It's the gift of nature that links music, a carver, a sawmill, a splintering clarinet, and the wildlife of East Africa. It's the wood of the Mpingo tree, the tree that makes music. At first glance, the Mpingo is like most of the other trees of the African savanna, an unassuming, thorny, gnarled, yellowish tree. But it contains a great treasure, one which becomes both art and music. It grows in a type of woodland that once stretched all the way from South Africa to Ethiopia in the continent's northeast corner. Now, the Mpingo survives only in Tanzania and northern Mozambique. The Mpingo tree, like many trees, is an important barrier against spreading deserts. In addition, it's a valuable factor in the fertility of this land because specialized bacteria living on the roots enrich the soil. And at the end of each dry season, its burst of new growth provides much-needed food for the plains animals. It may not look very impressive, but in its center is a remarkable wood. The Mpingo tree has been traded along the East African coast ever since the ancient Egyptians crafted its wood into ceremonial staffs, furniture, and ornaments. The Makande people who live in the southern region of Tanzania have also had a long traditional bond with the Mpingo, the national tree of their country. This man and his sons are traveling deep into the bush on a search for the best tree in the neighborhood. The ideal Mpingo tree should be straight and flawless. It must be at least 60 years old, big enough to justify the labor of cutting it down, but not too big to carry home. Experience and skill are needed to make sure the tree will land on a cushion of branches to prevent splintering and cracking. The Mpingo is prized for its jet black heartwood. It's also been called African blackwood and sometimes ebony. The wood is almost as hard and heavy as iron. Anything made from it is immensely strong. It's so tough that the axe needs sharpening every few minutes. It's thirsty work. The land is hot and dry. But those who know it know where to find a drink by cutting a vine that's full of water. After 2 hours of hard labor, the tree is still holding on by a thread. The Makonde are expert carvers. The heartwood of the Mpingo is very important in their lives. But the Mpingo plays an important part in Western culture, too. From it come some of the liveliest sounds in the musical world.
1, 2, 3, 4.
At a jazz band, or for that matter an orchestra, what you're looking at is a tiny ebony forest, because the fingerboards and the chin rests of string instruments and the black notes on a keyboard of a piano, and of course especially the bodies of woodwind instruments, oboes and clarinets, are all made in the top instruments from Mpingo wood. What you're hearing is nature's voice, a direct connection between nature and music. Connection couldn't be more direct. Here's a marvelous material, this wonderful black wood, which has proved to be the ideal material for making these, to making woodwind instruments, particularly clarinets. And it's for that reason, for those unique tonal qualities and sheer glamour of this material, that makers have been, since the 19th century, making instruments from this wood on an industrial scale.
Among the sawmills scattered along the southern coast of Tanzania, there are a few that specialize in processing Mpingo logs. Foresters in the bush provide this mill with about 600 trees every month. Since the Mpingo is used to make the finest musical instruments, only the highest quality wood passes inspection for export. Takes as heavy a toll on the teeth of the saw as on the carver's axe. The Mpingo wood is twisted and full of flaws, and extracting high-quality timber is extremely difficult. The graders reject most of the pieces. At least 90% of the tree ends up on the scrap pile. Once sealed and bagged, this wood is like gold bullion, the most expensive timber in the world. In the poor, parched country of southern Tanzania, water is a vital commodity. But the Mpingo is almost as crucial. Carved by Makande sculptors, it provides essential income to many of the families here. The extra revenue has allowed this family to build a small village for themselves and has made them relatively wealthy. A single tree may last 6 months. Very little of the precious wood is wasted. The small cuts will be made into souvenirs or chess pieces, while the larger pieces are worked into elaborate sculptures. The strength and hardness of Mpingo wood makes carving laborious. But these are the same qualities that allow the finished pieces to be intricate and fine. Mzee Hendricks has been carving for 30 years and is a well-known artist. He crafts a style of sculpture called Shetani, which features mahuka, ghosts of dead ancestors who were witches when they were alive.
Mimi ningependa kufahamu historia juu ya hiki kinyago unachochonga mimi. Kinyago gani?
Kinyago hiki ni kinyago aina mtu jitu mbaya. Linaishi porini. Linaishi porini na wakati mwingine watu wanapotea kutokana na mtu kama huyu. Nakula watu mtu akipotea porini. Huyu ndio mlaji wa watu. Midomo anafungua wakati anavyopita wewe. Anakudaka.
Wewe umewahi kuona?
Kuwahi kuona, lakini baada ya kusikia ni watu wanapotea kweli kwa sababu vitu kama hivi.
Na ulipata mawazo gani ya kutengeneza kitu kama hiki? Na wewe bado hujaona?
Mawazo baada ya kulala usingizi hapo unaweza kuona kila kitu. Kitu kikubwa kama hiki. Alafu unapoona, alafu unaweza kukumbuka na kuchonga pia.
Unaweza kuchukua muda gani labda kutengeneza kitu kama hiki?
Ni muda mrefu zaidi kama kutengeneza kama miezi sita hivi kwa kufikiria au kwa kukumbuka vile vile.
Na hapa juu ni kitu gani hapa juu?
Hapa juu ni kitu kama huyu ni watu wa moja wanashirikiana kukamata watu. Polini. Thank you.
The carving skills are passed from father to son, but it's only the imagination of the artist that can make the flowing lines of the sculpture live. On the outskirts of Paris, a new shipment of Mpingo wood from Tanzania is about to arrive at a factory of Boosey and Hawkes, one of the world's largest manufacturers of clarinets.
They call the bus.
Traditional methods and modern science have been combined to produce a series of secret processes for drying and treating the wood. The treated wood is aged for at least a year before starting the long process that will transform it into a clarinet. Like that of the Mpingo tree. It is so strong and durable that it behaves more like metal than wood. It can be cut with the great precision necessary for placing the finger holes. Can be turned on a lathe or bored through without cracking. It has exceptional stability under extremes of temperature and humidity, an important characteristic for instruments played by blowing air into them. Because each piece has its own individual character, it needs a craftsman's hand to turn the wood into an instrument with its own distinct personality. And it polishes to a beautiful sheen. But the wood still retains its organic nature, and when it comes alive again as a clarinet, it shows off its warm and beguiling musical tone. Michel Arignon is a top concert clarinetist, employed to put the new instruments through their paces.
Alors en fait, là, j'ai changé deux fois le pavillon parce que la qualité du son est bonne. Mais on cherchait à avoir un plus grand son par rapport à la moyenne des clarinettes. Et maintenant, je vais le tourner pour chercher le point où il va sonner le mieux. Et pourquoi ? Parce que ces deux parties-là, l'intérieur est fait d'une seule fois, mais pas cette partie-là. Donc il faut essayer de trouver l'endroit où ça va le mieux s'accorder avec cette partie-là. Je le fais.
Once matched and fine-tuned, this gift of the forest is ready to make music. But woodwind manufacturers are having a problem with Mpingo wood.
Since 45 years, I'm in the woodwind manufacturing business. Mpingo wood is still cracking. It can be happened that the wood has a little hair crack, and then when you put it into the lathe, it's starting cracking. And you have a scrap rate of about 20%. We don't know what's causing really these cracks, but when you're considering that this piece costing you $10, we'd like to know why.
Some people believe that the flaws in the wood may be due to the increase in the number of fires on the African savannah. Natural wildfires have always swept this land. The Mpingo is one of the many trees that has evolved to withstand the swift passage of occasional grass fires. Its bark may be scarred, but the tree is still alive. But we humans set fires on the savannah for our own needs, to clear the land for farming or to stimulate new growth for cattle. Man-made fires have upset the balance between the Mpingo and natural fire, a balance that evolved over millions of years. If scorched too often, the heartwood will be irrevocably damaged. Flaws in the wood are an expensive nuisance to the instrument maker, but to the environmentalist, they are indicators of a major ecological problem, something of deep concern to botanist Sebastian Choa.
Sehemu hii ilikuwa situ mzuri sana, lakini kutokana na moto uliotokea hapa kama wiki moja iliyopita, imemaliza ule msitu wote mzuri na umeisha. Mti kama huu mpingo umeweza kubakia hapa baada ya moto kumaliza miti yote midogo iliyokuwa hapa. Kwa hiyo mti kama huu utaendelea kubaki. Hii ni matatizo yanayotokana na moto, hasa moto uliotokea hapa karibu katika vijiji vya jirani karibu na msitu huu, na ukaweza kuingia na kumaliza miti yote katika msitu huu.
Now, young trees are being killed before they have a chance to grow big enough to become fire resistant. As Tanzania's rapidly increasing population demands more and more food, farmers are burning the land indiscriminately. These man-made fires, added to those that occur naturally, have dramatically increased the frequency of burning. Sebastian Choa is with the Tanzania Wildlife Society, a small but determined group of people doing what they can to protect Tanzania's natural resources. He is worried that the Mpingo is under attack from too many directions.
Sasa miti kama hii ikiwa kama itauawa na moto na ile miti mikubwa kama ule wa awali tuliuona ukakatwa kwa ajili ya kuchongwa vinyago na kazi nyingine, ina maana baada ya muda mfupi miti yote itakuwa imeisha. Hivyo basi kuna haja ya kuotesha mpingo.
Is the Mpingo going to vanish from the African landscape?
Well, it's not an endangered species in the same way we talk of elephants or rhinos or whales being endangered species. But with trees, you don't have to be on the brink of extinction to be under threat. If the standing stock of this tree isn't topped up at a rate that will sustain a harvest, then the tree will become, in effect, commercially or economically extinct. And that may not sound like a desperate threat, but experience in the past with other woods like teak, mahogany, has shown that once this economic extinction occurs, literal or biological extinction often isn't far behind.
The problem is already beginning to affect the lives of the carvers. Quality Mpingo wood is increasingly hard to find locally.
Tulifika hapa kwa kutoka kule mbali kwa sababu kule ilikuwa mpingo karibu. Ulikuwa mpingo karibu huko. Sasa baada mafundi walikuwa wengi na ikawa mpingo kule umekwisha na tunaendelea na kuchonga huu mpingo na mpingo uko hapa. Ndio maana tumetoka mbali kufika hapa kuja kufuata huu mpingo na kuukata. Ndio maana yake tulipofika huko.
Okay. Pole pole. Oh. Pole pole.
And it will be a long way home, too, with such a weight. Commercial logging trucks have to travel 120 miles deep into the interior to find decent stands of trees. Even where there are a lot of trees, those good enough for concert halls are few and far between.
Nobody knows how many Mpingo trees there are in Tanzania. The best guess I've seen on record is around 3 million trees. And the extraction rate, the number that are harvested every year, is somewhere between 20 and 30,000. That should mean, if the arithmetic was simple, that there are enough to go around for at least the next century. But as a matter of fact, only about 600,000 or 12 to 20% of those trees in the standing stock are suitable for harvesting at any one time. And they're not being replaced at the kind of rate that they ought to be. So that they're diminishing at 5% a year without being replaced. Unless something is done about this, within 20 years, there won't be an Mpingo trade anymore.
It takes at least 60 years for a sapling to grow into a commercially useful tree. But the young trees that should provide the forests of tomorrow are being burned today.
We are very concerned about the future of the trees because Hussein Hawks, for example, is one of the largest manufacturers in clarinet, and with their subsidiary company Bouffier Crambon making the Rolls Royce of the clarinet, it's our lifeblood. What alternative do we have to replace Mpingo wood if this is not available anymore? Plastic. But we know what kind of problem we have with the plastic, the pollution problem. Then there's the other way, finding another species of wood which we can use. To the best of my knowledge, In the moment, there's nothing available. And I cannot imagine that any professional player playing an instrument not made out of Mpingo wood.
Traditional lineup with a jazz band, I mean a 6-8-piece band with a front line of two brass, I don't think it sounds the same without the clarinet. Certainly a clarinet adds so much, especially on solos. I mean, you can get so much light and shade. And I don't really know too many bands, jazz bands, that don't use clarinet. The wood's so important. You get so many contrasts on the clarinet. You can play it fierce and up in the top, and nice and mellow in the bottom. You know, there's no substitute for it, I'm afraid. Plastic, I've tried, you know, and it makes a sound. It's all right, but I mean, it's got that warmth about it, that live sort of feel about it, wood. You can't beat it.
Just as there is no substitute for music lovers if the Mpingo disappears, there is no substitute in the African ecosystem if the living tree becomes extinct. The Mpingo is essential to the ecology of East Africa. The problems of conservation in East Africa tend to be seen solely in terms of the threat to animals, the elephants, rhino, and other mammals for which this land has become so famous. But animals and plants have evolved together. They are interdependent. The loss of any one piece in this concert of life would destroy its natural harmony, its very essence. Sebastian Choa has begun to do what he can to help save the Mpingo tree from extinction. He's persuaded local residents to give up parts of their gardens as nurseries for his young plants.
Hii ni sehemu tu ya miche 200 ya Mpingo ambayo nimeiotesha na baadaye nategemea kuipeleka porini, msituni. Na kuitunza kabisa ili sipatwe na janga lolote la moto. Na baadaye tunategemea kwamba inaweza ikatumika kwa matumizi kwa mfano ya kutengenezaji vinyago, vyombo vya muziki. Hii ina maana basi ni hatua nzuri kabla ya hali haijawa mbaya zaidi ya Mpingo.
Replanting and controlling fires are the first steps toward protecting the Mpingo. The gift of nature that links a sawmill, a carver, and a musician has given life to cultures around the world in art, music, and science. simple dollars and cents. In Tanzania, the Mpingo trade for musical instruments alone is worth $1.5 million a year. A lot of money in one of the world's poorest economies. And the tourist trade for wooden souvenirs is growing all the time. Carving provides an income for many hundreds of people flooding into the capital of Dar es Salaam from the rural areas. The finest sculptures are much sought after by collectors in Europe, America, and Japan. They command high prices. In essence, it is the cultural value of the wood that may well determine whether the Mpingo survives. Although Makande's sculpture has reached an international market, it is the Mpingo sound that has traveled to nearly every country on Earth. And that suggests a role for music in its conservation.
Whatever you may feel our civilization, our society lacks, two things it really prizes above all else, and that's music and quality in music. You have a $1 trillion recording industry striving for the utmost fidelity in the reproduction of sound. You have a performers who dedicate their lives to the ultimate, making the ultimate sounds, and craft workers making the ultimate instruments. Now, none of that is of any avail if raw materials like the Mpingo are going missing. The music industry, I think, has to recognize that it's been paying something like half price for this resource, and it should enable Tanzania at least to draw the same revenue as it gets now from it, and top it up with enough to pay for proper management of the tree in the field. And that doesn't just mean the timber trader or the instrument maker, but it's the whole spectrum of music interests, right through from the performers, musicians, the orchestras, and the recording and broadcasting companies, and the individual music lover. Everybody has a part to play.
Choice. It's got to be wood. It's got to be African black wood. Not only for me, but for thousands and thousands of people who will not only play, but listen as well. They'd hear a different sound. They'd hear a different tone, you know, different thing altogether. It's got to be African black wood, I'm afraid.
Miche hii miambili ya mpingo ambayo nimeotesha ni bure kulinganisha na mahitaji katika nchi hii. Mwaka ujao ninategemea kuotesha miche zaidi ya 1,020 ambayo nina imani kwamba wenzangu wataniunga mkono kwa kuiotesha mingine zaidi. Kwa maoni yangu binafsi, naona kabisa ndio njia pekee ya kuhifadhi misitu ya mpingo katika nchi hii kwa manufaa ya siku za baadaye.
Uchangaji wangu ninapendelea kuhusu mawingu bila kuwa kama shetani. Siwezi kukaa hivi hivi baada ya kazi ya kuchonga na ijua. Nimeona ninapendelea sana kwa kuchonga hiyo vinyago. Ninapendelea sana kwa utamaduni wetu wa Mwafrika.
En fait, je crois que ce serait terrible si on ne pouvait plus disposer du bois. Parce qu'en fait, on n'a pas trouvé le matériau synthétique qui pourrait remplacer le bois. Il existe bien des clarinettes d'étude en plastique, mais on ne peut pas dire que ce soit vraiment au point. Alors, si on ne disposait plus du bois d'Afrique, on ne pourrait plus jouer Mozart, on ne pourrait plus jouer Weber, on ne pourrait plus jouer Brahms, ni Webern, ni Berlioz, ni Boulez, ni Donatoni. Ce serait un peu triste quand même.
The Mpingo story reveals that conservation of tropical forests, far from being a distant concern, actually lies at the heart of some of our most cherished interests and values. If we look after it, it will repay us with that most precious gift. Music. Nature is made possible by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting and by annual financial support from viewers like you. Your local gas company and America's natural gas industry. Fueling power plants for a cleaner environment. And by Canon. Quality and innovation for the way we work and live. Canon.